Okay, so start off by closing your eyes. And it's one of the starting points, but just closing your eyes is actually quite nice because you tune out of so much of that information that comes through the eyes. So much our mental space is preoccupied by the faculty of sight. So leave that to one side by closing your eyes, and then you can start to feel your body properly. So feel your body and make sure that you are nice and at ease. We're going to be sitting here for about 40 minutes or so. I hope you're okay with that. So find that ease and comfort of the body here. And when the body is nice and you have no pains and problems in the body, the next stage is then to learn how to really relax. And the deeper you can relax, the better it will be for the meditation. So take a lot of time just to, again, find the ease of the mind. And one of the ways of doing that is to actually experience the body, because body and mind are always tied together. And you can often feel the lack of ease in the mind by tensions in the body. So focus on the body and allow those tensions to dissipate. Take a few deep breaths in the beginning, for example, and just gradually have a sense of kindness and compassion towards yourself, and allow yourself to find that ease in the body. Often it is just a matter of taking time, of being patient, and just waiting in the present. And if you can remember the simile of the armchair, you're not trying to meditate. The trying often gets in the way. All you're really doing is learning to relax, not doing anything, allowing the energy to come back into the mind, dissipating all the tiredness that has kind of weighing us down through the week and through the day. So sit back, relax, and just allow the mind to calm down by itself. you will tend to find that when you let go in this way, that the mind does one of two things. Either it is tired or it keeps on thinking. And in both of these cases, don't try to control these things. Meditation is not about controlling the mind, but it is really about allowing the mind to be here. So if you do feel tired, don't fight the tiredness. Just go with the flow and see what happens. If you do find the mind thinking, again, don't suppress the thinking or try to control it, but allow it to happen. And as you allow it to happen, and you just try to watch what is going on, these things tend to disappear gradually over time. And you can just imagine yourself like a passenger on the train. And as a passenger on the train, you have no choice about the scenery. You look through the window and the scenery is always changing. But there's nothing much you can do about it. You just observe, you just sit back, and you just accept whatever is going on. Meditation is a bit like that. You are a passenger, not a driver. So don't judge the scenery, don't judge the thoughts, don't judge the sounds coming from outside. Just allow things to pass by without interaction, without any kind of rejection or acceptance. Just the bare awareness of what is going on. And as you do that, you gradually learn to flow with phenomena, trying to control or trying to do anything about it. And if you find that the mind is lacking in energy, very useful to do is to again lift the mind up a little bit by some sort of a positive reflection. And maybe often the most powerful reflection is simply to remind yourself of the good company that you are in. What a blessing it is to have people like this who are like-minded, who enjoy this kind of practice, who can support you in this practice, leading in the same direction. People who are good spiritual friends. How fortunate I am to have people like this in my life, heading in the same direction as me and leading to similar kind of results. And if you do start to calm down a little bit, maybe even experiencing a little bit of joy, please notice those beautiful feelings and perceptions that arise in the mind. And you will notice and be able to feel that freedom from all the duties of life, all the things that you have to do in ordinary life. All of that is gone. And what replaces it is a sense of ease, a sense of peace, a sense of the self dying down. Notice how delightful that is. And as you notice that, your mind will incline in that direction, towards meditation, towards the spiritual path. And as you carry on in this way, there may come a point when you certainly feel that the breath is there, the breath is present, as if the breath is coming to you rather than you going to the breath. And then when your breath arises in this way, in a sense, you're already doing the breath meditation. Make sure when you do this that the breath is more like a companion. The breath is not someone you control. The breath is not like, the breath is someone you're walking with rather than someone you are observing. And it means a very light kind of touch with the breath, allowing the breath to come and go pretty much the way it wants. It's like a friend, not someone you're controlling. Okay, so coming close to the end now, before we come to the end, just take a few moments to evaluate your meditation. If you do feel a bit more peaceful and relaxed than at ease, ask yourself why that is the case. And if you don't, also ask yourself the same question. Okay, so that is the end of the meditation for now. So let's have a nice lunch, and then we'll meet again at 1 o'clock after lunch.